Ciryl versus Lewis. What is your thoughts on that fight? And then what is your thoughts on Derrick, I'm sorry, Ngannou sitting out and them doing interims and stuff? Like, do you think, what's your thoughts on the whole thing in general?
Well, I think with Ciryl, I think he's so gifted. I think he's the heir to that crown. I really believe that. And of course, he has to get by Lewis to prove that I'm correct. But his abilities have shown cat-like reflexes for a huge man. He's well-versed in all the areas of MMA. Smart guy, well-spoken, great body for fighting. I mean, he knows how to use distance extremely well. I think Lewis, though, has the H-bomb factor.
Yeah.
And he could be losing the fight through and through, losing every round, and the last second hits you with the haymaker that puts your lights out.
Yeah.
So that's what Lewis always has. But if you fight Lewis correctly, like for instance, when DC was offered to fight Lewis, we jumped at the opportunity to fight Lewis because we had the kryptonite for him, and that was the wrestling.
Yep.
The wrestling, the pedigree of wrestling that DC had. We knew that he was in trouble. There's nothing he could do because he couldn't defend the level of wrestling that DC was.
Right.
But Ciryl Gane doesn't have that level of wrestling.
He's well rounded, so but he's not a wrestler.
That's a whole different story. So you can say whatever. Oh, DC wrestled him, just wrestle him. Okay, well, you know what? I think another good fighter, Division I wrestler, tried that, and I think he got the bad end of that one, right?
Yeah.
So you just can't not think you're just going to wrestle Lewis and get him. You can't. You're going to have to fight him, you know? So I think Ciryl's going to win it because I think he's just so well-rounded in all the areas of intelligence, striking, endurance, the whole bit. But Lewis got the H-bomb factor, and that's – that's my thing. He has the H-bomb factor, and that could end the fight. And as far as Ngannou and the interim titles, in this case, I think it's the stupidest thing I've ever heard of. I mean, the only reason why Ngannou is not fighting is because they couldn't come to contractual, situations where it's, okay, done deal, we're in. So why create an interim title? Okay, that's your right, you can do that. But to me, this is not an interim title. This isn't even a title fight. This is a head
contention. It's a contention fight. It's a title contention fight.
It's the number one contenders fight. Yeah. And you know what? I get why they're calling it a title fight because people hear title fight and it creates more buzz. But I think the real hardcore people know this is not a title fight. And I think that's fine. The promotion doing that is okay. But I think the real hardcore people know that at the end of the day, it's like, you know, the real champion is Ngannou. And the only reason why he's not fighting is because they couldn't come to terms. Just like John Jones, can't come to terms with them, and that's it. So it's just a matter of, putting the pen to the paper and the money and the deal in place, and then you got a deal. But right now there is no deal, and I don't know what's going to happen if Ngannou and the UFC are going to come to terms. Maybe they will. Maybe they won't.
Yeah.
And maybe the fact that this interim title and they don't come to terms with Ngannou and they release him, then it does become the real title. So I'm just kind of backtracking. I just proved myself wrong, because here's a situation where an interim title does become effective, because if they cut him, then these guys are legitimately the champion now because he lost his title outside. So I'm wrong. I just got corrected myself. Thank you for helping me.
There you go. And two things I want to say about that. Number one, I had two title contention fights, and they weren't for interims, and that sucks. Because I would have much rather lost those fights and lost an interim belt than just lost those fights and lost nothing. And so I would have at least rather fought for a belt in those two fights. But and the other thing, too, is Derrick Lewis has the post-fight thing, so it's like if you lose to Derrick Lewis, it's like you're gonna have to wake up or get up and hear about his sweaty balls, and like it's just it's got to be just not a good feeling if you get knocked out by Derrick Lewis and then he's making his comments. So not a fun loss, I think. My opinion on that, though, is I think Ciryl is a well-rounded fighter. I think he's gonna win, in my opinion. I love Derrick Lewis. I'm a Houston guy, but I think Ciryl Gane is just too well-rounded, and I think he could get dropped with that big punch, but I think overall he's well-rounded. And then for the interim, I agree with you 100%. I don't understand it. I think it should just be a champion, and he gets his belt taken away or not. And the thing is, if Ngannou got his belt taken away, if it was his fault and he didn't get a fight, whatever the case, he fights the winner of Ciryl versus Lewis, and then he becomes another time champion because he wins the belt again, and he should be able to beat those guys if he's a champion. So... real quick, real quick, real quick, with Mike.
Swick.